Hard to get them started again occasionally.
Second down, there's the option going left. He'll take this up just shy of the 40. Excellent display of footwork on that run. The keeper gets him 7 that time, but it'll lead to a third down.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it. And while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
It's a gain of 4, and it gets him the first.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you could actually be pushed back before the first down. It's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the first down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Panthers.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game film, and only if they manage to win the game.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. Down and avoids the contact by sliding. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. So the offense has it first and 10. Newton turns and hands to Stewart. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. To throw is Newton. Back of the 29. Fletcher Cox in there to get him for his 2nd sack of the night.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
From the gun on 3rd down, Newton. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. The 12 yards that time and picking up the first.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll make this a 2nd down. Off to Stewart, and he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the 1st and goal.
Well, as the play call comes in on 3rd down, you have to think about 4-down territory here. Down a few touchdowns, they need points, and they need big points.
And now he'll tuck it and run. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain there as he kept it himself at 2nd down. 1 quarter remains until the NFC crowns its champion. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we're back now in Charlotte. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. spotted at the four. It's second and goal. Now Stewart. And he gets halfway home from the four down to the two-yard line. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action, throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. And he just did get those feet in there on the side of the end zone. Well done.
Probably the exact size foot necessary, because I think if he had another half size, that catch doesn't count. And he's able to get it in, and it counts for a touchdown.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. And this is up and good. That'll make it a score now of 24-10. Gano out to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you. You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
A give to McCoy. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. The Eagles on third down. They've been tough to stop. 8 for 10 so far. This is third and four. They'll look to throw. Ertz over the middle. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now a first down carry here for McCoy. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line. Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
And some room to work. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to make it fourth down. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. Now this offense ready to head back out there. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
fourth quarter, every drive's so critical, and you figure they only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On first down, it's Newton. And he finds his man, the tight end Olsen. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Here's Newton. And a right side completion here by LaFell. It goes as a gain of 8 and moves the chains.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Now it's Newton. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. So now it's first and goal. From the gun, here's Newton. 7 yards on the play, and that'll bring up a second and goal. Second and goal as the offense looks to try to, and he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Jonathan Stewart taking it in, and the Panthers have got it back to a one-score game.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
And he knocks it through. Gano out to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And right now they're just looking for a little more cushion, trying to make this a two-score game. Points here would go a long way, obviously, to propelling them into the next round.
And this is where the head coach, offense coordinator, they've had to set a tone all year long about what they do on offense. So most teams want to stay in attack mode, but you have to do it with some bit of caution, don't you? Because you can't come away with no points. You need these points here in order to feel a lot better about where they are in this game.
But this time of the year, playoffs, game of this magnitude, this is what we hope for.
Yeah, it's exactly what we hope for. You want to run your offense cautiously, but not so cautiously that you just give it up.
Back to throw. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Julius Peppers able to collapse the pocket and drop it for a loss of a yard. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down, make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
And a nice spin into some open field. And he gets this inner that time. This one goes for 19 yards. I think this defense tired of seeing him run the football on this D-line. Probably getting sick of the O-line as well.
And as I'm watching this, I'm thinking about a conversation I had with Adam Gase, the head coach of the Miami Dolphins in the offseason. He told me that he asks his running backs each week for their favorite runs. Give me your 3 top runs. And right now, you're seeing a guy that's probably using his top runs to great advantage in this game.
He is in a zone. And the coach has decided to throw the red flag. He will challenge this play. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
Let's go!
They'll drop the throw. Able to spin free. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it second and goal. Second and goal, ball on the 7-yard line. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. He'll wind up getting 3 on the keeper there, but it leads to a 3rd down. The 4th quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up to the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
They'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a 4th down.
How about that for defense? Every hole plugged up. Can't run it inside, can't bounce it outside. That sets up 4th and goal from the 2. Right now, advantage defense.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So his 2nd field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the 4th quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
Now it's Sturgis converted on the field goal. Now he'll send this one away on the kickoff. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn it into a play action, and throw one deep.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Newton. He finds some open field here. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. On 1st down, Newton. And over the middle, it's LaFell. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the 1st down completion. Great changeup there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
Well, the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside, make a move in that direction. Then you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him and the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way.
And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. What a big hit at the 19. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. Time for a break. Back with more in the NFC Championship game after this. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. In the red zone this time. From the red zone now, Newton. Caught on the left side by Ginn. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now it's... And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Ronald Darby.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down two scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They're in a good spot. Two-possession game, barely, but a two-possession game here late. Now they just have to put this game on ice.
Let's face it, right now, they're talking about ball security, taking care of it, not allowing anything crazy to happen, because we've seen nutty things happen down the stretch. But they also have the security of the scoreboard. With that type of a lead, even if something goes haywire, they're still in good shape.
Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So the defense... A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
And that does it for the conference championship. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And for our entire crew, we'll see you 2 weeks at the Super Bowl. This is the NFL on EA Sports.